Joining us now, Sean. Kentucky Senator Rand Paul. Senator, this is beyond chilling. What did you hear? And when you hear the numbers of John and Sarah, what does that tell you?
You know, it's sort of mind-boggling. We've been hearing rumors, and anonymous sources have been telling us for a couple of months now that they believe that the Obama administration was spying on other presidential candidates other than Trump, and that it may be politically motivated. Now, I don't have the evidence. I haven't seen the evidence, but I've requested it. I've asked the White House to look into it, and I've asked both of the intelligence committees. There are about eight members of Congress who know more about spying, and they get all of the information that most of us are not privy to. I've asked those eight members. These are the gatekeepers. There's something called a Gates notification. If they looked at my personal information, if they listened to my phone call, they're supposed to have a Gates notification, and there's supposed to be someone who knows that this happened. I've never been notified, and so my question is, are they supposed to tell me they're spying on me, or do I have to request it? But now that we've gotten these sources, I have made formal written request to find out if the Obama administration did indeed spy on me.
Senator, we're going from 654 to over 2,200 in a year.
It may be even worse than that. When we spy on foreigners, we gather up maybe as much as a million pieces of information on a million different Americans. Now, they've looked at 30,000. So what you're hearing about is the ones they looked at, but they have a million different phone calls, transactions, emails from Americans who have talked to people overseas. The danger is, if they're willing to use this for political purposes, what if someone's making an international deal and buying a company and it's top secret? It would be devastating to your stock price to know you're negotiating a deal with a foreign country or with a foreign company. What if someone decides to sell that to your competitors? Well, we can't have our intelligence agencies listening to anybody willy-nilly without a warrant.
Senator, this is deep and profound. We're talking about trampling on Fourth Amendment constitutional rights here, unreasonable search and seizure. There are laws and procedures in place here. One, Brennan, Clapper, Rice, Rhodes, Jarrett, and maybe even the president knew about this. You're the lawmaker. Espionage Act. Tell me the laws that could have been broken here and how dangerous this is to a free and open society.
The main protection we have in our country is you have an independent judiciary. The police have to call a judge to listen to your phone call or to come into your house. What's happening here is there is no warrant for the American. The American's just being scooped.